You can win $32,000 on the turn of a card on Card Sharks. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful Jeep Wrangler. And now the host of Card Sharks, Bill Rafferty.
Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody. Welcome to you guys at home. Thank you, Bob Hilton. Thank you very much, sir. Welcome, everybody, to Card Sharks. Let's get started right now. We've got a lot of prizes to give away, hopefully a brand-new Jeep Wrangler. Let us pick it up where we left off last time. Let's meet our lovely dealers. Here they come, Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Yes. You swept back your hair. And you switched earrings. Or no, you didn't switch earrings.
No, we're still wearing
the same earrings?
Can I get those off first?
Okay. No, let's get started right now. We're going to pick it up in our second game, and let's beat our Card Sharks. Here they come. Hello, Ray.
How you doing, Bill?
Ray is our champion, everybody. He is a... you live down in Long Beach,
yes,
am I right,
I do.
Sir? And married with a couple of children.
Right, 15 years. I work for a computer company. I'm a credit supervisor.
Mm-hmm.
And I love outdoor and indoor sports. And one of my favorites is volleyball. It's like volleyball, but it's played in a racquetball court.
Well, I thought it had a speech impediment. It's like a volleyball. I like that. What do you mean it's played in a... Explain it to me. I've never heard of it.
Well, have you ever played racquetball before?
Yes.
Okay, you put a net through the center of the court itself. Lengthwise or perpendicular, mm-hmm. and you just play like volleyball, but you hit it off the walls. It's great fun.
Wow,
great.
I never knew that. Anyway, he is the champion, by the way, and he has $14,590 to prove it.
Thank you.
Let's say hello to Peggy. Peggy, introduce yourself, please.
Hi, Bill. My name is Peggy Normandin, and I'm a college instructor from Southern California, and I have a 9-month-old son of whom I'm very, very proud.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, how nice. What's his name?
Hello, Frankie.
Hello, Frankie. I'm sure Frankie just said, oh, hello, Mom. How are you? Good to see you. Okay, good luck to you. She has to win this game, by the way. We're in the middle of our second game, coming up with our second question, and she's got a good start ahead here. She is 4 cards turned over. She turns over the next one. She ties it up. So let's get started right now. Okay. Don't forget about our prize card in the deck. It's already up. It's a trip to Hong Kong. So here is our question, and it goes to Ray. We surveyed 100 married men, and we asked them, when you have romantic daydreams, are they usually about your wife? How many married men said they do usually daydream about their wife?
I would say the majority of the men. I do, most of the time. Just kidding. No, but to be honest, I think the majority of the husbands do. I would say that's a high number of 82.
Most of the time, Ray.
Well, when you say
some
fine ladies like this up here.
Don't explain that to me. Don't explain that to me, but I think there'll be a chat when you get home, Ray. Anyway, Ray says 82. Peggy, what do you think?
Well, my husband is very amorous, and I love him dearly, but, you know, daydreams are fantasy. So that will be lower.
You're going lower than 82.
Yes.
The actual number of married men who daydream about their wife is 67. It is lower.
Oh.
It is lower. All right, let's go over here. Peggy, you got an 8.
Can you guess? I'm going to change that card.
Yes, ma'am. That 8 now becomes an 8.
Oh, lower.
Lower. She gets it. She ties the match up, and she's one step closer to Hong Kong. And there it is. Oh. Way to go.
Closer to Hong Kong. I like to
send you that. Very good. Okay. Let's get going right now with our second game. It is a tiebreaker situation, 3-card game, a maximum of 3 questions. The ladies are setting up the board for that right now. And here is our first question, and it goes to Peggy. Educated guess, Peggy. When a dollar bill becomes worn out, the government takes it out of circulation. According to the Treasury Department, on the average, how many months does it take a new $1 bill to wear out?
How many months?
How many months does it take a new $1 bill to wear out?
Well, it doesn't get worn out in my hands, I'll tell you, because it changes hands very quickly. I will say 12 months.
12 months? What do you think, Ray, higher or lower?
I think it's going to be a lot lower than that because of the exchange constantly of that money. I think it's going to be lower than
that. A little bit lower than that? I think you're right. I think Ray is right. I think it is lower. He's going with, Peggy says 12 months, Ray says lower. The actual number of months it takes a new $1 bill to wear out is 18. It is higher. It is not lower. So, Peggy, here we go. Let's see what happens. Take a look. You've got a 7.
Thank you. change it.
Sure. Now becomes an ace.
Lower
than an ace, it is a king.
Lower.
This is it. Game match, Hong Kong. There it is. That is terrific. Listen, Ray, we want to thank you
thank you so much for being here.
You're going to leave us with a new Jeep Wrangler, $14,590 cash
and
prizes.
Had a great
time. Good luck, sir.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Come on over here, Peggy.
Thanks, Ray.
Come over here. I want you to listen to Bob Hilton tell you all about Hong Kong.
You and your guests will enjoy the comfort and service of Northwest Airlines as you fly to Hong Kong in their giant jumbo jet. You'll have six nights at the famous Park Lane Hotel overlooking Victoria Park in Causeway Bay. Enjoy Far East cuisine and luxurious accommodations. A vacation package worth over $3,000.
All right, thank you, Bob. You know, she was, if you've been watching her play, she was very disheartened. You were pulling lousy cards. Never thought she'd be here, but here she is. When we get back, she's going to the money cards. We'll see what happens, right? Here we go. Lacey and Susanna are dealing out the cards, and Peggy's going to play for the money. In addition to all the money she can win, we've added that joker to the deck. And, of course, anytime it turns up in the money cards, she gets a shot at that brand-new Jeep back there. And because she's the champ, we give her a joker. We guarantee her at least one chance at it. And let's get started right now. Let us give her $200, please. All right, Peggy, let's make some money here. You have $200 and a king.
All of it lower.
All of it lower than a king. Here it is. $400 on a jack.
All of it lower.
All of it lower.
Woo.
All of it lower than a jack. It is. $800 on a five.
Change it with number one, please.
Yes, ma'am. Let's get a good card up here. Five now becomes a six.
Ooh. Okay.
$800 on a six.
$50 higher, please.
Conservative bet. She says $50 higher than a six. She gets an eight.
Oh, an eight.
You have $850. I'm going to give you $400 more, $1,250.
All of it lower.
You got it. All of it lower than an ace. Be there. It is.
Yay.
2005.
Change that card with number two, please.
Oh, she likes this. She likes this game. All right. That seven now becomes a three.
Ooh.
Okay. You've got $2,500 on a three.
Excuse me. 1,000 higher, please.
1,000. 1,000 higher than a three. There's a seven.
Yes.
3,500.
Okay. $100 higher.
$100 higher than a seven. It is a deuce. Smart
okay.
bet. Okay.
I like
so
it.
Now.
I like it.
Now you've got 3,400 and a two.
All of it higher.
All of it.
Yes.
I had a feeling she was going to say that.
Yeah.
Another two shows up. It is a push. No win, no loss.
Well,
but 3,400 higher. It is. You did it. $6,800. Not a bad shot of the cards at all. All right. That brings your total to $10,000 right now. Let's take, here is Susanna with your joker. Why don't you hold on to this joker, and Bob will tell you all about the Jeep.
It's the Wrangler continues the tradition that made the Jeep a legend with room for four. The Wrangler offers personal control, comfort, and the flexibility to enjoy both on-road and off-road driving from Jeep Corporation. Good luck.
Okay, here we go now. Right in front of you, seven numbered cards. Behind one of them, the word car. Find it, and it's all yours.
Okay,
As if by wizardry, she was drawn to number one. I thought you were going to put it here on six.
I know.
But you said, forget six. We're going to go to number one. You were drawn over there.
My number one son.
Number one son? All right. There's the reason. Let's take a look. Is the number one son going to pay off with a brand new Jeep Wrangler? No, he is not. You got to have three more kids. It's behind number four.
I'll do that.
Okay, you can hit it. There it was. Okay. It was behind number four. Okay, we'll be back with a new challenger. She's got $10,000. Don't feel sorry for her. We'll be right back. Here we are. We are back right now, and it is time for us to bring out a new challenger. Let's get started and meet Ron. Come on, Ron. Welcome, Ron. Introduce yourself, sir.
Hi, my name is Ron Pagano. I'm an Italian-Irish boy from Boston. I came out here to work in Videoland. I'm a big-time movie buff.
You are?
Yeah.
Good for you. Welcome to you, sir.
Thank you.
Don't forget, of course, we've got the prize cards in the deck, and we've got a trip to Puerto Vallarta. That
Whoa.
Is in there, too. Okay, now I've got some news for everybody here. This is our final match of this season, and we want to make sure that there is enough time for you guys to get to the money cards. So, if you hear this sound, Don't go and answer the door. That means that time is up. And every question after that is going to be sudden death until we get ourselves a winner. Okay? Let's get started right now. First question goes to Peggy. Audience poll group, 10 married women with us. Come on up, ladies. We've had them with us all week. They have just been a terrific group of ladies. Give them a nice round of applause. They're a lot of fun. Okay, Peggy, this question is for you. Before the show, we asked these 10 married women, have you ever surprised your husband when he came home from work by greeting him at the door totally nude? How many of these 10 women have surprised their husband by greeting him at the door totally nude? And how many husbands said, well, I guess we're not going out to dinner? Is that what So, Peggy, it's for you. What do you think?
Oh, ladies. Let's see. I will say two. Two of you have done that by accident.
Two? By accident? By... Holy smokes, I forgot my dress. I would you have... What a nitwit. Hey. Okay, Peggy says two by accident. Ron, what do you think?
I don't know. These ladies don't look like that sort to me, but if they are, I want to know what neighborhood they live in. I'm going to say that's going to be lower.
It's going lower, huh? Okay. Two, lower. The actual number of these women who have surprised their husband by greeting him at the door, totally nude, is two. Oh!
Just lucky guess.
Is this the voice of experience that we're talking here, that you knew this? You realize, of course, you've just picked up $100. Good for you. Who are the two ladies who did this? Whoa, Lisa and Dolores. My word. Thank you very much, ladies. Have a seat. Thank you. That was very nice. Whoa. Okay. Here we go. Peggy. Take a look at a queen.
I like it. Lower.
Lower than a queen. It is a three.
Higher.
Higher. It is a king.
Lower.
Lower. It is a jack.
Lower.
Lower again. We're talking game number one. There it is. Whoa. Right through.
Unbelievable.
That was terrific. All right. We're going to be... Somebody get the door. No, that means that this is it. This is sudden death time. That means every question here on out is sudden death. Okay? So Susanna's dealing out the cards. Let's get started right now at game number two. This question is for Ron. Here we go, sir. We surveyed 100 men over the age of 65 who are retired. And we asked them, if you could have continued working past retirement age, would you have done it? How many retired men said they would have continued working past retirement age?
You know, my dad retired just recently, and I think he was ready to. I don't think that's going to be that high a number. I'm going to say around 35.
35? Mm. Peggy, higher or lower?
I'm sorry. I'm going to have to ask you.
How many retired men said they would have continued working past retirement age? Ron says 35.
I will say lower.
You're going even lower than that.
Lower than that.
The actual number of retired men who would have continued working is 45. It isn't lower. It is higher. All right. It's sudden death. So what we're going to have to do right now, so you have a choice to make here, Ron. You want to play or pass. Let's turn over both of these base cards so you know what you want to do here. Okay?
Okay.
Turn over Peggy's. And I'll turn over Ron's. We'll share this. Okay? You want to play or pass?
I am going to pass.
He's going to pass it over to Peggy. Okay, Peggy, you're playing off a nine.
Lower.
Lower than a nine? It is an eight.
Higher.
Higher. Every turn of the card. Sudden death. Higher. No. That means that Ron did it. All right. Now we've got ourselves a tiebreaker. Very nicely done. A little disjointed, but we're going to get through it. Here comes the tiebreaker. Lacey and Susanna are going to set the board up for that. Three cards, maximum of three questions, of course. And again, every question is sudden death right here. Peggy, this question is for you. Deal those cards, ladies. Here we go. We surveyed 116-year-old girls, and we asked them, do you think it's important for a girl to be a virgin when she marries? How many 16-year-old girls do think it's important for a girl to be a virgin when she marries?
Oh, what a question. I think at 16, I hope that, yes, it will be higher. I hope it will be high. So I will say 60.
60? Ron, higher or lower, sir?
You know, at 16, I think that's going to be a little higher number than even 60.
A little higher than 60. The actual number of 16-year-old girls who think it's important for a girl to be a virgin when she marries is 75. It is higher. Ron, right to it. Okay, again. We look at Peggy's card, and we look at Ron's card. It's a play or pass scenario.
I'm going to pass to Peggy.
All right. Sudden death, tiebreaker. Whoever does this goes to the money cards. Peggy?
Higher.
Higher than a six. It is not, and Ron wins it.
Oh, this is
thank you.
Ooh, good.
Peggy, I don't want to rush you off, but I want to get to Ron and the money cards, but thank you for being here.
I loved it.
$10,100. Thank you so much. Okay, Ron, come on over here.
Thank
good
you.
Job.
Thank
very
you.
Very good job. We'll be back with Ron and the money cards right after this. Welcome back. Here we are with Ron. Ron wants to go and make some money. We've already dealt out the money cards. He knows how to do that. But before you start betting the cards, I want you to know that we've taken all the jokers out of the deck. That's the bad news. The good news is that Susanna is holding all of them for you right now. This is our last show of the series, and this is your last chance to win a card this season. So in honor of that fact, we're going to give you four chances to win the card.
All right. Okay? All right.
I want you to get the card.
I hope so.
Okay. Let's get started. Give him 200. There it is. Here we go. Make some money, Ron.
All right.
$200 and an eight.
I'll change that card with number three.
Number three. You can change one per line, as I've said, and there is a seven.
Okay, I'm going to go $100 higher.
$100 higher than a seven. Tough call. It is a four. $100 on a four.
Okay, $50 higher.
$50 higher than a four. It is a three. $50 on a three.
$50 higher.
Go get him. $50 higher than a three. It is an eight.
Okay, okay.
All right. Not a great run.
Not a great run.
But you've got $100. I want to give you $400 more because we're on a second level. You've got $500 and an ace.
Okay, all of it lower. All of it lower.
All of it lower than an ace. Here is an ace.
Oh!
No win, no loss, a push.
Okay.
But you still got $500 and an ace.
Still, all of it lower. All of it lower.
All of it lower than an ace. There it is.
Okay.
$1,000.
$750 lower.
$750 lower than a jack. It is.
Whoa!
Now you can pick up some change. Now you can make some money. You've got $1,750.
Do you know?
Yes.
All of it higher.
All right, here it is. $1,750 higher. It is.
Yeah! Woo! Thank you.
Very nice. Very nice.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Let's get started right now. You got $3,500. Here they come. We've got all four jokers. All four jokers are for you, because you're going to have a chance to win this brand new Jeep that Bob Hilton's going to tell you all about.
It's the Wrangler. Continues the tradition that made the Jeep a legend. With room for four, the Wrangler offers personal control, comfort, and the flexibility to enjoy both on- and off-road driving. From Jeep Corporation, good luck to you.
Okay, we're ready to do it, sir. You got four chances to do it. Behind one of those seven numbered cards is the word car. Find it.
Two. Three.
What is it?
Four.
Which one?
Whoa!
Aye. This makes me nervous.
Makes me nervous,
four
too.
Four chances to do it. I'm going to start from the end, and I'm going to go forward. I've never done it this way before, but hey, it's the last show. Fire me. Here we go. Is it behind number six? No, it is not. We got four.
Okay.
Is it behind number four? No, it is not. It is 50-50. Which one do you want me to turn over?
Number two.
You want me to turn over number two? Is it behind number two? No. That can only mean that it is number three, or you're getting a cab.
I'm getting in a cab.
You're getting in a cab?
No.
Bet again.
Oh!
Yeah, you did.
Yeah! Thank you.
Woo! Very nice.
Yeah!
Car.
Woo!
Get in your car.
Yeah.
Get in your car. Very nice.
Okay.
I am so hot. $15,265 cash and prizes. What a way to do it.
Here we go.
That is just terrific. What a way to end the season. I am so
thank
happy
you.
To be here. We'll be back right after this.
That's great. That's great.
Welcome back. Ron was so excited that he won the car, he left. He's gone. No, we wish him good luck with over $15,000 cash and prizes. final show of the season. As I said, I want to thank these two lovely ladies. They have just been terrific. Pay attention to the crawl as it goes up and down. You'll see lots of names. Those are the people responsible for the high quality of this show has been through the whole season. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
In the end, only one of us will be left standing.
Deal the card. This way, some poker.
If you don't know who the weak player at the table is, it's probably you.
Oh, my God.
Just pay attention. Focus. It's good for your game.
I should have brought $1 million.
I should have known better than to bluff that idiot.
Well, they're not going to do the moves I do. You got to play the players.
Come up against me. I'll bury you.
High Stakes Poker. Tomorrow night at 9, 8 Central, only on GSN.